Okay, dah. Coba deh, lu cek di YouTube gitu.
Itu BBA ya?
Okay. Ada. Tapi dia emang katanya nge-lag 20 detik.
Enggak, tanda darah enggak ada.
Hah?
Enggak kok gue. Gimana cara nyari user sih?
Ini yang link gue kemarin. Kasih, ntar gue kasih lagi.
Oh iya, iya, lupa. Oh iya.
Ada.
Ada kayaknya live nih. Kenapa mata gue? Ada. Yeay.
Ada kan? Alhamdulillah.
Alhamdulillah. Ya benar agak lag ya.
Iya. Dia nge-lag tapi nanti YouTube-nya tapi harus kita ini, harus kita apa namanya?
Matiin.
Yes. Ya lu matiin aja ya. Kalau lu kan enggak perlu, lu matiin aja. Kalau gua harus gua tutup. Nah, ini gua tutup suaranya.
Ya.
Ya kan? Suaranya udah enggak dobel-dobel kan? Tapi memang dia udah ngomong 20 detik nyampenya.
Ya, lu matiin aja. Kalau lu kan enggak perlu, lu matiin aja.
Nah, itu.
Kalau gua harus gua tutup.
Oke, udah ada yang datang.
Iya.
Yeah. Ada yang datang nih. Gua terima apa gua suruh nunggu?
Nunggu ya.
Coba tunggu dulu aja ya.
Ini gue lupa.
Ini lu mau share screen ya?
Enggak.
Enggak.
Belum. Blank. Mau dah.
Oh, gue yang share screen kayaknya.
Lu baru share screen.
Oke. Dah, siap-siap. Terima deh.
Okay, gue kamar mandi.
Ada Audrey. Oke, gue yaudah lu matiin dulu ya. Yeah. Gue terima orang nih.
Bentar, gue buka, gue di mana ini dia.
Assalamualaikum Kenzi. Assalamualaikum Audrey.
Waalaikumsalam Tante.
Karissa sama Isan mana bareng sama Audrey pakai satu lagi?
Enggak, mereka sebentar lagi datang. Mereka pakai juga sendiri.
Ya udah, ntar kita sambil tunggu teman-temannya ya. Masih okay. Pokoknya berapa menit lagi? Ada 8 menit lagi. Assalamualaikum semua yang baru datang. Kita masih tunggu teman-teman yang lain ya. Toh, mau ngobrol-ngobrol dulu, mau kenalan dulu sama yang lain. Sini kita udah ada Nindita ya. Nindita dari Bahrain ya. Ada Audrey, ada Kenzi, Ihsan, Lutfi, dan Aska. Insya Allah kita mulai 5 menit lagi. Hello. Apakah?
Tante Dara, you turn off your microphone.
Dia tadi ngomong ternyata mute. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Kenalin dulu nama nama tante, Tante Dara. Tante Dara mengelola bermain bersama anak. Hari ini kalian belajarnya bareng Tante Gita. Sebelumnya tante mau kasih selamat dulu buat kalian sama thumb up. Keren banget karena kalian hadir tuh tepat waktu. Yeay. Jam 10 itu kalian udah hadir di sini. Thank. Bahkan ada yang beberapa sebelum jam 10. Karena salah satu kunci sukses nggak cuma hanya masalah public speaking, masalah attitude, tapi gimana kalian bisa tepat waktu itu salah satu kunci sukses kalian. Jadi sebelumnya, selamat sekali lagi. Sekarang sebelum kita mulai, kita baca doa bareng-bareng. Apa bisa nggak dibuka mulai sekarang ininya? Untuk sementara buka video dan mikrofonnya ya. Setelah Tante Gita, nanti setelah Tante Gita memberi penjelasan, ditutup lagi mikrofonnya. Videonya tetap dibuka. Oke, bismillahirrahmanirrahim. A'udzubillah minasyaitonirrajim. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Kita baca Al-Fatihah bareng-bareng ya. A'udzu billahi minasyaitonir rajim. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Alhamdulillahi
rabbil alamin.
Ar-Rahmanir
Rahim.
Maliki yawmiddin. Iyyaka na'budu wa iyyaka nasta'in. Ihdinas siratal
mustaqim.
Siratal ladzina an'amta 'alaihim. Ghairil maghdubi 'alaihim. Amin. Satu lagi doa mau belajar. Robbi zidni
ilma
warzuqni fahma. Oke. Nah, ada satu lagi nih doanya. Ini doa yang berkaitan sama kelas yang sekarang, doanya Nabi Musa. Mungkin kalian udah pada hafal. Yang belum hafal sih bisa dihafalin, doanya pendek. Ini doa Nabi Musa ketika Nabi Musa diperintahkan Allah menghadap Fir'aun. Dan Fir'aun itu kejam, bukan main. Nabi Musa takut gitu, ada perasaan takut. Gimana aku ngomongnya nanti? Nah, kalian bisa baca doa ini karena yang akan kalian hadapi ke depan enggak sekelas Fir'aun, paling cuma ibu-ibu, bapak-bapak, teman-teman. Jadi enggak usah setakut itu. Jadi kita baca sama-sama doanya ya. Bisa dilihat di layar kan? Robbi
sadri amri wahlul 'uqdatan min lisani yafqahu qawli.
Oh my Lord, open my chest for me and make my task easy for me and untie the knot from my tongue so that they understand my speech. Insyaallah bagus banget kan ini doanya. Insya Allah kalian bisa praktekin doa ini setiap kalian harus berbicara di depan publik. Nah, selain doa, kan kata Allah nggak cukup cuma doa ya, harus ada usaha juga. Nah, setelah doa kita akan usaha belajar bagaimana caranya berbicara di depan umum bersama Tante Gita. Untuk waktu dan tempat, silakan Tante Gita.
Terima kasih Tante Dara. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi
wabarakatuh. Terima kasih adik-adik semua sudah datang dan on time. So, once again, thank you very much for you to be on time in this session today. So, I would like to share something. Can you see my PowerPoint now?
Not yet.
Yet, okay. Tante Dara, I should, I mean, you should stop your sharing first, then I can start my setting, isn't it?
Oh, now we can see it. Now we can see
it. Oh, you can see
it.
Yeah,
now we can see it.
Okay. You can see it now? Really?
Yes.
Okay, sure. So how many of us now in total? I just want to check for a while before we start our session. Okay. So 16 participants, so minus two, more or less. We already like 14 of us now. The one that registered is actually 23. So can we just wait like another 2 minutes for your friend to come? Is that okay, guys?
Yeah.
Okay, thank you very much. I just want to actually... Okay. Okay, I would like to say welcome to the class to Nafisa Nabila, Aisa Marlianto, Enzi Atabani, Audrey, Marisa, Lutfi, Iza, Muhammad Rafi, Aisha, and then Ihsan, Aska, Darel, Tiara, and Dafa. Okay, so before we start, may I know in which class are you in? Okay, I'll call you one by one. Nafisa, which class are you in now?
I'm in class
in which grade?
Grade 8, is it? I'm going to grade 8.
Oh, see. Okay, thank you. Aisa, in which grade are you now? Aisa Marlianto, in which grade are you now?
Grade 9.
Grade 9, okay. Lutfi, in which grade are you now?
About to go to grade 8.
About to go to grade 8. So 7 to 8. Rashad, can you hear me? Which grade are you now?
I am in going to 6th grade.
Going to 6th grade. Okay. Audrey, in which grade are you now?
Sorry. I'm going to university.
So, because this is actually for the middle schooler and high schooler, hopefully Audrey can get something from here, okay? Because in our last slide, I show something about in the university. So hopefully you also can get something. So Carissa, in which grade now?
I'm going to grade 10.
Grade 10. Iza and Rafi is actually in a different device. I thought you will be in the same device. So Iza is actually going to be grade 9.
Yes.
And then Rafi is going to be 8, is it?
I'm about to be grade 8.
Yes, okay. And then Kenzie, you're in which grade now?
I'm going to grade 7.
Grade 7. And then Aisha is? So more or less, we have grade 6, grade 7, grade 8, grade 9, and then university. Ihsan, in which grade are you now?
I'm going to grade 8.
Grade 8 also. Okay, Aska.
I'm going to grade 8.
Grade 8 as well. Daryl, in which grade are you now? Is Daryl here? Or I move to Tiara first. Tiara, in which grade are you now?
Or Dafa? I'm in grade. I'm going to grade 8.
Yeah, Tiara is 8. Okay, Daryl is on 7. Ihsan is 8. Tiara 8. Dafa.
I'm going to grade 9.
9, and then okay. I think that's it, right? All of us is already here, so it's. More or less, you're in the same grade, around 6, 7, 8. Okay, some of you 9, some of you in the university. So hopefully, today's topic can cover all of you because this is actually a very general. Okay, Tante Dara, can we start now? I think.
Yes, sure.
You should.
It's already. Like 5 minutes past.
Oh, ah, minutes. Okay, yeah. Okay, it's better.
Past 10 already, 10 minutes past 10.
Okay. Then, okay, I will start sharing. It's already like 20 of us. Okay, that's enough. So I start sharing. You can see it now, right?
Yes.
Okay. So, Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. As you might aware, today we will discuss about public speaking. So, this is actually general information about public speaking. So hopefully you can actually relate with your own experience in the classroom. Before I start everything, some of you might already know me, Tante Gita probably. We meet many times in Riyadh. But if I'm not mistaken, it's based on the list that Tante Dara sent me, kids that actually coming from outside Riyadh. UK, Bahrain, Jakarta, Yogyakarta, and then Qatar. So my name is Gita Gayatri, or you can call me Tante Gita. I'm actually working as a senior lecturer in Department of Management, Faculty of Business, Universitas Indonesia. Started 1999 until now. I am a housewife, a mother of two. You might know Tanisa and Atan. Meet them probably many times in Riyadh. And my education is started from my undergraduate master degree and PhD is in marketing. So whatever I convey today, it's actually based on my experience, not only as a lecturer, because I also taught some subject related to the public speaking, which is called business communication, but also based on my experience as a student, because I was a student once, right? Now, the agenda for today, I will actually give you some introduction about public speaking, and then the preparation stage of public speaking, and then including how to handle the anxiety, as well as what should you do during the presentation, and I also include the group presentation because some of you might have to do the group presentation inside your class. And then I end up my presentation with some examples. Okay, so hopefully within around 1 hour or 1 hour something, I will finish all the subject. Some rules in this class. So this is not something that very rigid. So if you can, please try our best to cope with all of this etiquette in Zoom. First of all, during my presentation, when I talk, please mute yourself, okay? That helps me to actually give a clear voice. The second one, be on time. Tante Dara have discussed about this be on time thingy, but this is actually something that's important for you to do. The third one is actually, please turn on your video as much as you can. Okay, Tante Gita, I cannot because I was actually somewhere else or I'm going to reach home in 5 minutes, fine. As much as you can, please turn on your video so I can see your face. You should prepare, like for instance, you want to ask something, you want to take a note out of something, you might actually provide some, I don't know, notes and pen next to you. Sit still, okay? Be respectful, and then try to find a quiet place so no one will actually, no voice will actually bother you. If you want to actually ask some question, you can raise your hand or you can write in the comment box. So after we finish, then we will discuss about your question. So you are allowed ask as many as you can. Tante Gita, I don't want to speak. I just want to write. Fine. It's up to you. Choose anything that's convenient for you. And then last but not least is no eating. But probably some of you, because in UK, if I'm not mistaken, still ate something. If you haven't taken your breakfast, just do. That's fine. you can actually turn off your video and then start eating and then drinking, it's fine. Because within the presentation, I might have to drink something when I actually my throat is very dry. So if all of the ethic is actually, everybody's understand about the ethic, let's start the session. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. I will start the session with a quote from Ralph Waldo Emerson. He's a philosopher. And he said that all great speakers were bad speakers at first. Okay. What does it mean? It means that it's not something that instantly you can get. Like you were born, suddenly you were born with the capability to speak in front of the public very well. So it, but somehow it can be learned. Okay, along the time within your life, you can actually learn how to do good speakers. How to conduct good public speaking. Okay, so don't worry if you think right now, the Gita is still actually very hard for me to speak in front of public. I'm shy or whatever. Whenever I have to actually speak, I cannot actually get out anything from my tongue. Fine, it's fine, because all bad speakers were bad speakers at first. Okay, so. What is actually public speaking? The presentation that I just actually doing. What is the definition of the public speaking? Public speaking basically giving or delivering an oral presentation, just like what I do now, to talk, to discuss, to suggest, to explain, or display a topic in front of the audience. Okay, by sharing your thoughts, your ideas, or probably questions with others, you might actually face various numbers of audience, various kinds of audience, either the general audience or in front of your classroom. So you have to face your classmates, group of people, examiner, for instance, judge, let's say, if you are actually doing some competition. A reviewer, a teacher, it can be anyone. Your audience can be anyone. You are facing them, in front of them, to speak and explain about something. That's the main thing about public speaking. So if you can relate this thing with whatever you experience inside the classroom, for sure you've done so many public speaking by now. If you are in the grade 6, 7, 8, or even in university. Now, there are three purposes of public speaking. Okay? If you want to actually convey something, there are three possibilities for you to convey about the topic. First one, if the purpose is to persuade. Okay? So this persuasive type of speaking is the way you are change the perception or behavior of the audience regarding a certain topic or idea. Let's say you want to persuade your classmate to stop using plastic bag. So you are actually telling what will be the impact, the negative impact of plastic bag, and then what will happen in the future. Then you are actually trying to build the argument, please start to minimize or stop using the plastic bag. It's persuasive type of public speaking. The second one is informative. So if in informative, you are actually presenting an information, facts or general knowledge. Like most of your class assignment is actually informative. But in some assignment, probably also persuasive. And finally, the third one is entertaining. It gives happiness and cheer to the audience. Let's say a stand-up comedian is also entertaining type of public speaking, or probably a magician is actually the entertaining purpose of public speaking. Okay, so PIA, persuade, inform, and entertain. Now, I would like to invite Tiara, is Tiara here?
Yes.
Okay, Tiara, Can you see my cursor here?
Yeah.
This is the first one. What purpose do you think that this boy is actually presenting?
To inform.
To inform. Why you say it's to inform?
To give the description of the book that he's presenting.
Exactly, because he's actually giving the description about the book. So definitely that the purpose is actually to inform. Thank you very much, Tiara. And then I would like to ask Dafa. Dafa, can you see this one? Which yeah. purpose do you think they are actually speaking about?
To persuade.
Do you know who is she?
Is that Michelle Obama?
Exactly. Do you know who is
Abraham Lincoln?
Exactly. And him?
I don't know.
Martin Luther King. Yes. Okay. So three of them are great speaker in persuasive type of public speaking. Exactly. Thank you very much, Dafa. It's very good. What is it? Explanation and answer. And finally, Lisa, can you help me with this one? What do you think the purpose of this man in front of the class is? It okay? This one.
Entertaining.
Okay. Why?
Because he is doing like magic or
exactly
in front of the students.
In front of his student, the teacher is actually trying to actually teaching something, informing something, but by doing the entertainment purpose, okay, to the children. So it can be actually combined. You might actually persuade someone by giving some information. What is it? In the early time. Why you can persuade? Because you give the information first. Or like this man, like this teacher, he's actually giving the entertaining type of public speaking while he's also doing something informative. So it actually can be combined. Good job, guys. I move to the next slide. How we should do the effective public speaking. In the beginning, I will start with what should actually we prepare prior to the public speaking that we have to do, okay? At least there are 6 steps of effective public speaking. Gita, I think there are more steps for sure, yes. Probably in different literatures, probably you might find more than 6. But at least I highlighted 6 of them. The first one, before you are actually doing the public speaking, try to analyze your audience. Try to analyze your audience might help you to understand what will be their background, whether they will be interested with the topic that you will convey or not. If you know your audience, then you will easily determine what will be the topic or goal of the presentation that you will choose, okay? Because sometimes your teacher probably let you to decide what are the things that you want to present, let's say like that. So you should think, who are they? To whom you will actually doing the public speaking? That's the way you analyze your audience. And what should I present that related to the topic that you will actually brought up? Why I need to present this? Oh, this is part of the assignment, let's say. And where should I present it? Inside the classroom. Or probably the teacher said that we will do the outside class presentation. Fine. So if you able to actually understand your audience and determine your topic, and then knowing the context, why you have to present, where will you present, you might actually get a clearer view about what to do in the presentation. The next step is planning. Planning related to something like you make the framework. What are the things that I will generally speak to the public or to the audience that will see me? In order to be able to plan, you might do research. Okay. What is the research? Function. The research is actually to gather as much as information about the topic that you will present. Okay. Now, this particular research actually making your plans work, you need to make sure that the source that you take for this particular presentation, in order to make the presentation, in order to write the presentation, is actually coming from the reliable sources, the trusted sources. Because if you are actually, let's say, quote from something that opinion, but you are actually presenting about the data, it might be not match. You have to make sure that first, the source is actually reliable. Then second, the data is actually related to your topic. The third step is to draft and revise. Drafting, and then if you find another information from the other sources, then you actually revise. So it's actually the iteration process. When you are drafting, you have to think some of the thing like this. First of all, is it the thing that I draft, the presentation that I think I will present, either you are actually drafting by writing all of the thing that you will present, or you are actually putting the dots, what are the things that I need to present, is it too short or too long? Let's say, within the class assignment, usually your teacher will give you a time limit, right? You can present in 15 to 20 minutes, like, let's say like that. So you have to actually predict whether it's actually too long or too short. Will it be boring or will it be making our audience excited? How about the introduction? Can I choose good introduction so they are actually hooked by presentation and engaged to me the whole time I present? And then whether I used good transition words. Transition words means from one topic to the other topic, usually you have the whole topic and then you have some subtopic, right? Between the subtopic, you need the transition words that lead to the next topic. So whether you already make that one or not. Do you need more data or examples to make your presentation clearer? You need a visual aids. Is it the presentation that you prepare is actually easy to understand? Does it has a good flow? Those are the things that you should actually ask when you are drafting the presentation. The fourth step is you might, okay, this is optional, you might prepare something called speaking notes or the cue cards. Or sometimes people call it index card. So something that you can hold, sometimes when you are actually holding something in front of you, whether you finally read it or not, it like help you to, what is it, ease the nervous feeling when you are actually presenting in front of the class, right? Now, this cue card or index card or speaking note should consist only points, okay? Should consist only points and not actually the whole thing that you will say. It depends on you. Some people is actually drafting the whole thing, then they are actually making it short as a point in your, what is the name, cue card. Okay, the thing is the points, the keywords, the ideas, the important data, those are the thing that suggested to be available in your cue card. But remember, the cue card is only there to help you. Stop looking at the cue card during the presentation. You should actually maintain the eye contact. I will explain about the eye contact later. The fifth step is actually practice your presentation well. I might say this is actually the most important step during the preparation. Okay? Remember the proverb. Practice makes perfect, of course. If you practice, the more you practice, the more you are actually know about your things, the more you are actually remember about what are the things that you will convey to your audience, and then it will also increase your confidence, okay? Because you know, I know what are the things that I want to say. So by practicing, you also know how much time you spend. Okay, so if the teacher said that in the instruction it's only 15 minutes to 20 minutes, then you know that you should actually present within that particular time. Without practicing, how do you know you will spend 15 to 20 minutes? So you should do the practice. as much as you can, even if possible. And finally, this is only a suggestion. Prior to the presentation, prior to the public speaking, prior to the class presentation, try to sleep well. Try to actually drink or eat properly. Sometimes people said, I cannot eat because I'm too nervous. No, don't do it. You should eat. But the thing is, it's not like overeating or over drinking. But the thing is, you have to eat and drink something. Otherwise, if you are hungry, then the nerve will break you even more. Okay. Try to also on the appropriate clothing and comfortable shoes. So those things is actually making you more relaxed during that time. Is it clear up till now? I hope you, if you're nodding, then it will be fine. Don't forget, you can ask anytime in the chat box, okay? So during the drafting, the composition, when you are actually doing your writing on your presentation, there are at least three things that needs to be there. The first one is the introduction. The second one is the body, the thing that you will speak. And finally, closing or conclusion. These three things you have to keep in your mind. It has to be there in everything that you do, including class assignment, writing assignment, class presentation assignment. For both cases, it's actually the same. You need to actually do the introduction first that lead to the topic itself, which is the body, and then closing to summing up everything, okay? Don't forget about these three things. Now, I want to actually raise this insight because it seems, I'm not saying it's always, but it seems for most of people, this anxiety is actually something that you really, really, you don't want to have it, but somehow it appears during your presentation, prior to presentation, a couple of minutes before your presentation, even sometimes. It makes you finding that it's hard to sleep at night, probably. And before your presentation, you feel like your heart beat very fast, like want to explode, and then sometimes probably shaky, your palm are actually, wet, sweating, and then wobbly legs, and then sometimes like I want to faint, I think something like that, choking. Happens, okay? So it happened. The thing is, I want to show you how to handle this anxiety. First of all, it's totally normal. You know what? It's totally normal, okay? So if you are thinking that why I always feel nervous before my presentation in the class, it's okay. Everybody also feel the same. Me, even like, for instance, if I can calculate how many times I have to speak in front of public with the possibility of me having anxiety, I can say in each and every time I have to speak in front of public, even in front of you now, I also feel the anxiety. Okay. Like last night, it is hard for me to sleep until I said to myself, I really need to sleep. Otherwise, I will actually feeling sleepy in the session. The thing is, you have to know first it's normal. So you don't have to actually, making it as a big thing that it's actually bigger than the presentation itself, okay? Next, you might actually try to develop self-confidence, lessen your anxiety. How come I get self-confident, Tante Gita, if I'm actually too afraid to face the class? You can do many things. First of all, you can actually practice. Remember I told you earlier about the practicing? By doing the practice, probably practice in front of your family, practice in front of your close friend, let's say, might somehow develop your self-confidence. And you might also think positive energy, to think something positive before you are actually presenting something. So bring the positive energy to your mind might actually increase your self-confidence and it will reduce your anxiety. How to bring the positive energy? You have to think that, okay, I've learned everything. I'm the one who make this presentation. Somehow I have to be confident that I'm actually best knowing about this particular topic compared to my other friend in the classroom. So I should actually confident enough to deliver this topic to them. Okay. Or probably you might think, calm down, Gita, in 15 to 20 minutes, in 1 hour, like 4 hour session, it will be finished, then you will be okay. So it's just like 15 minutes, 20 minutes, just be confident out of that particular time only. Fine. Your hand might be actually cold, feeling cold. Your feet might be wobbly, but if you are confident enough, then you can actually convey everything as planned. Next, give a good start and maintain your breathing. Good start. I keep telling about a good start. You see, when you are actually watching a movie, let's say, what movie do you see? Oh, okay, let's say Harry Potter. Hopefully some of you already watch Harry Potter. Harry Potter, the first. I forgot the title of that Harry Potter. Remember when Hagrid is actually bringing Harry Potter to the family of Harry Potter, the uncle and auntie? And then when he was a baby, and then the Dumbledore said that it's not a goodbye, we will actually see him again when he's ready. That's a good start. Make you as an audience curious about that particular movie. Okay, that's a good start that makes you hook into that particular movie. That's a good start that makes you, okay, I want to see what happened to this boy. What happened to this boy next? Okay, especially if you're already watching the trailer. So like in the movie, during the presentation, you also need to give a good start in order to make your audience hook to you. Tante Gita, if they are hooked to me, then they will look at me all the time. Fine. There is a way how you are actually handle that particular thing. Okay? The thing is you should actually give a good start. That's why you need to plan. If you remember our previous slide, you need to have a good plan about your material, and then you can give a good start. You can test your family whether it's a good start or not. And try to maintain your breathing. When you have a good start, people look at you, then try to maintain your breathing, inhale, exhale properly. So you are not like, suddenly everybody is looking at me just because I make a good start, something like, no, you should not do that, okay? You just give a good start and maintain your breathing. Like you should focus on what you are saying, okay? You are not like, distracted by someone is actually going outside your class, let's say, or distracted when you are seeing your friend doing something, or you are actually overthinking too much about what will be their opinion, what will be my teacher saying. Just focus on what you will say, what you are saying. Okay, make sure you already say everything as planned. Take your time. Make a pause. When you are probably forget about something, make a pause and do not rush. You might use your gesture to help you to ease the anxiety. Like you see, my hand keep moving along the time. I don't know whether you can see my hand or not. That's actually to make me remember what I will say and then to reduce my anxiety. Next thing is keep going. Sometimes this anxiety comes because of, say, technical difficulties. Oh, something wrong with my laptop. Why suddenly it cannot move? Why the internet is actually stopped? Why everything has to be now? No, don't be like drama queen. Just keep going, okay? Even if you already have the PowerPoint, a good PowerPoint, good planning, somehow there is technical difficulties that it off. Fine, just continue what you are actually doing. Because mistakes does happen. Accident does happen. Keep your communication to your audience. Keep actually saying your main idea and get over it. nothing, whatever just happened, you just like, okay, remember, I still have like 10 minutes to go, then I will have to present all the rest thing within 10 minutes. Just keep going. Try to again, inhale, exhale, but do not actually think, overthink about something that not going according to your plan. And last but not least about this anxiety, your audience want to know something from you. Your audience is ready to hear something from you and they want you to succeed, okay? All they think is actually not how to actually make you stop explaining and then we can actually love him, her. No, they really want you to succeed. Your teacher even, they want you to succeed, okay? So you can actually reduce the possibility of anxiety by doing all of those things that I see. Okay, clear enough up till this point? Okay, I hope some of you are already nodding. Now, we already discussed about the presentation, the preparation. We already addressed about the possibility of anxiety and how to handle the anxiety. Now we move the main thing, which is delivering the presentation. What are the things that needed? Okay, for this part, I might actually will stand. Hopefully you can see me. I'm not sure whether you can see me or not. Can you see me now? Yeah, can you see me, man? Just nodding. Okay, thank you. It's clear, right? Okay, now, the first thing that might help you is for you to smile at your audience. Smile, you're on candid camera. Why you need to smile? Because first of all, smiling is actually contagious, okay? When you smile, you are actually making you more calmer, and then you also make your audience feel welcome, okay? So they might also smile of you, and then you are, okay, everybody's smiling, everybody's not giving a grumpy face, something like that. So you are actually calmer. Next is actually feel confident about your presentation. Again, like I said before, how to handle anxiety. You know the topic, you make the topic, you have actually prepared for the topic, you did a research, the extensive research. So be confident about the thing that you will say. Oh my God, it seems that my friend before me is actually saying more or less the same thing with what I will present. So it won't be actually interesting anymore. No. If you do it by yourself, it must be different. There must be something different. Feel confident about it. And then you can learn that next time for the next assignment, it means that you need to actually thinking out of the box when thinking a topic. So it won't be similar with your other friends, okay? Just relax, just keep going. You should actually feel confident about whatever you do. That's why a good preparation is actually a key. Next, make an eye contact to each audience. Why I said each audience? The audience actually expecting you to actually engage with them. Okay, so like for me now, actually seeing the camera, it's easy for me because I'm seeing the camera and I'm seeing actually some faces of you, because some people is actually turn off the video, some others is actually turn it on. So I face you now, okay? Why I need to make an eye contact is not only because it makes the audience feeling welcome by you, but that's also something that properly do during the presentation, for the formal presentation. Okay. How to make an eye contact and the Gita? If I see their eyes, I just actually bang, blank. I cannot remember what I should say. Okay, the eye contact is important. But if you find some difficulties in facing their eyes directly, okay. Let's say this is the head of the audience, okay? You face the eyes, slightly raise your side a bit upper, like seeing their forehead, okay? By doing that, if you are actually looking at them, but the thing is you are actually safely looking at their forehead, and then move around looking to the other forehead. that might help you to actually reduce your, what is it, nervous by facing, by doing the eye-to-eye contact. Okay. It is important to make the eye contact. Let's say some people saying that if you face something, then you are actually seeing their eyes and then slightly moving to the right and then seeing the other people slightly moving to the left again, left front, for instance, and then slightly moving to the right front. So it's just like the Z along with the audience that actually seeing you. So make sure you are actually giving enough time to see your audience eye. Okay. Next, be sure to have the inflection or tone in your voice. The inflection is important like this. If your voice is not strong enough, how will people at the back of your class can understand you or can hear you? Okay. The voice should be big enough, but not too loud. And then in some thing that you want to emphasize, you might actually make it more heavier. Okay? When I said that practice is important, then I actually emphasize about practice. The preparation, especially the practice, is actually the most important. Although all the preparation is also important, but the practice thing is actually makes perfect. How you are adjusting the tone, adjusting the voice of you. But make sure you are speak, what is it? Loud enough, but not too loud, okay? So everyone in the classroom can hear you properly. Next, humble hand motion to emphasize the topic. So 1, 2, 3, remember about the purpose of the public speaking, I said? Persuasive, informative, and entertaining. That actually hand motion that emphasizes the topic. But it's not like you are moving freely like this, including your body. You might actually move your body, but it's not too much. Why you cannot move your hand or body too much during the presentation? Because it's distracting. So your audience, instead of hearing what you say, they keep actually following whatever you do, and then how come this person is actually dancing in front of the class instead of presenting something that I want to hear. So make sure humble hand motion. It means you can move your hand, not too much. And then you cannot just like doing this, yeah, today presentation. Better actually move your hand to help you overcome the anxiety. Sometimes it can help you to remember things. Next thing is, convey the presentation in formal manner. This is something that important. When you are doing the class presentation, the assignment presentation has to be conducted in the formal manner. Okay, what is formal manner? The formal manner means you are putting on the right clothing. I will discuss about clothing in the group presentation later. You cannot actually like doing this by while presenting or putting your hand on your pocket, okay? Or like moving your body like this while seeing the ceiling of your classroom. No, you have to actually stand sturdy, make sure that your posture is actually good, and then move from the let's say you are actually presenting, there is a screen at your back, move to the screen and then back your audience, and not actually presenting by facing the screen, but actually your audience only can see your back. Okay, that's a formal manner that you are conducting everything formally. Next is try to be punctual. If you are given 15 minutes, you have 15 minutes. Try to finish before 15. If you got 20, then before 20, you should actually finish your presentation, okay? This thing is actually very important because for some lecturer, for some teacher, if you are exceeding the time, the allocation that you are given, then it will reduce your marks probably. It means you cannot actually manage your presentation well. And last but not least, you need to have a good conclusion. So sometimes, possibly, some of your audience gets lost in the middle of your presentation. But if you are making a summary and conclude everything at the end of your presentation, so Rashad is actually telling about this. So now I understand. I'm a bit lost in the middle of his presentation. Let's say like that. So have a good conclusion. Remember, you can actually prepare your conclusion from the very beginning. Now I will continue my presentation while sitting down again. Hopefully, that part you understand. This is the summary that you have to smile. Summary of the previous slide, not the summary of this presentation or this topic. Smile, confident, eye contact, voice, gesture, and conclusion. Easy. The sixth thing during the presentation that you need to remember. We then move to the group presentation. What is the difference between individual presentation? The previously is actually individual presentation. More or less is the same with the group presentation. The difference is that you are doing it in group. Two or more friend of yours, okay? Two or more students in your classroom. Now, what makes it different? Because it's actually not individual job, not individual task. You might actually do something. For instance, when you got the assignment given to you by your teacher, try to schedule a group meeting as soon as possible. The Gita is actually Corona time. Oh, fine. You can actually always meeting online like now. Okay, just try to schedule a group meeting because it's crucial. Okay, remember during the preparation for individual, you need to actually prepare 6 steps. It also happened in your group presentation. You need to analyze audience and topic together with your friend. Okay, this is no more that you have to determine yourself, but you have to do it or determine it with your friend, with the member of your group. Discuss who should do what. Okay, I'm doing the research and then I will compile everything. Then you guys actually make it as a PowerPoint. Fine. As long as it's actually fairly divided, then it's fine. Stay in touch for continuity. For my students, usually they barely having a face-to-face meeting. They do it through the Google form, Google Doc, something, Google document. So they're making, they share the doc, and then the other friend in the other end, probably in their house, is actually, oh yeah, I make some amendment. I correct this, because you are wrong, something like that. And then the other said, oh yeah, I also actually revise it, this. Stay in touch for continuity. Remember, this is actually the work of like maybe two or more heads. Probably the idea is different. If you are not staying in touch, then it might be between one subtopic with the other subtopic might be not related. And your teacher will easily notice. Did you actually work together or you work by yourself and then you work by yourself at the end of the time, you just compile? Don't do it, okay? That's actually the one of the mark reducer point that usually teacher will think. Because this is a group work. You need to work as a group. So make sure you are stay in touch for the continuity of your presentation. Everyone should be comfortable about who will do what. Oh yeah, during the presentation. Okay, the sharing about the presentation, sorry, the sharing about the planning is actually done. How about the sharing about the presentation? Oh, I make the introduction. Okay, I will actually me. And let's say Isa will do the body. We will actually split into two. I will be explaining the first half and Isa will be the other half. Okay, hi, Dara, you should do the conclusion and you are actually doing it properly because each and every member comfortable with that. Oh, yeah, okay. I think I know how to have a good conclusion out of our presentation. Let's say Tante Dara said that. Then that will be fine. The group work is actually done. The whole group should be present for practice. Remember, practice makes perfect. So you should do the practice. There is possibility if you already manage the continuity, if you know what are the things that you should present, you might actually record your presentation. Make sure that you are actually following the time allocation. let's say if you have 20 minutes and there are 4 person who will present, each person get around 4.5 minutes, let's say. 4.5, because you have to consider there is probably like technical difficulties, setting or everything. So don't make it 5 minutes, so 4.5. So you still have around minutes extra. Then you combine together and then you are evaluating together. I think you are too long in discussing this, otherwise all our message will not be conveyed, let's say like. So you should actually practice in a group, okay? Method can be very, can be together at the same time, then can be with the video that I just mentioned. It's up to you as long as you are practicing before presentation itself. And during the delivery, while other presenting, the other might actually helping by showing, see, you see in this picture below, one is actually presenting because she's actually holding the microphone and her friend is actually displaying the visual aid. Oh, so this is our project, something like that. So make sure you are working together. Not like when your friend is actually presenting, the other three is in the corner just talking without actually paying attention. Don't do that, okay? So the whole presentation, 20 minutes, your group presentation, try to focus on your group presentation, and when your friend are saying something, you should actually also pay attention. The outfit. Okay. I already said earlier that you should present in the formal manner. Okay. Remember, you are not actually using this for your class presentation, but one day you might need it, like let's say these girls and boys are doing the competition, and because they already get used to what will be the clothing that they use, used to on the formal clothing, then it's fine for them. It's easy for them doing all of those things at that time. So when you are practicing now in your classroom, one day you'll need it. Okay, one day you will need it. If not, probably in your high school, university. Audrey might be no the university, and probably when you are working, you will need that again. Okay, for the outfit, try to ask your teacher first. Is there any dress code? Oh, the dress code is actually allowing me to put on jeans and t-shirt. Fine, then use it. Okay, but for the normal thing, do not use jeans and the normal t-shirt, okay? Because it's not proper. It's not actually formal. You might try to plan your outfit 1 or 2 days before the day. Make sure that everything is actually properly chosen. Okay. If there is no information what to wear, then just use your uniform. You can actually, let's say your teacher said that put something nice, okay, put something nice and formal, but do not actually overdo the dressing. They say, oh, the teacher said it has to be something formal. I will put on my dress for the prom night. Oh, okay, you know you don't have to. You are not using your prom dress into the class presentation, okay? Unless probably the topic is about the prom, let's say like that, then it's probably fine. So don't forget to ask your teacher again. Perfect, nothing. No hole, no wrinkle, no like the feather of your cat everywhere. Why? Because your audience will actually be distracted by those things if you are not paying attention with them. How come there is a hole inside his clothes? A shirt is actually having a very big hole, something like that. So they won't actually listen to what you're presenting, okay? Accessories. Is it allowed to use the accessories? Most of the time in the classroom, you are not allowed to use the accessories. Probably like my daughter, having one of his assignment actually present about the place that they will visit or the place that they will actually promote. They choose Hawaii. So they are using the hula skirt probably, and then the cheerleader pom-pom thingy, and then the bandana and flower necklace. Those accessories, if it is allowed in by your teacher, your classroom, then you can use it. Okay, it's actually to enhance your performance. That's fine. Next thing is try to avoid the bright color. Bright color again might distract your audience. And finally, make a backup. You never know what something happened. Okay, even though you don't have a backup, you should actually, like I said, move on. Just it's okay. As long, because I don't know, it's actually it was raining today. Suddenly, when I'm going to school, suddenly the rain comes, all my clothing are wet, then it's okay. When I'm actually going to have the fever, no, masuk angin, then fine. Better you have a backup. So you just prepare a backup in case something happens. Okay, the outfit clear? Now, handling the question. Usually, not only in the group, but also in the individual presentation, some questions might arise. Okay. The first thing is try to determine the rule of the Q&A. Remember in the beginning of our presentation, I said if you have anything to ask, you might actually type it in the chat box. You might actually raise your hand. So you might actually say that as well. Or probably because your time of presentation is 15 minutes and then 5 minutes for Q&A, you might say, we will only answer the first three questions. And fine, you determine the rule. So you are actually comfortable with that. You know that I'm expecting probably 1, 2, or maximum 3 questions only. So it will not make you nervous. Next, you should focus on people who ask the question. Okay, please come again, Carissa, you want to ask something? So I'm actually seeing Carissa now because I'm actually paying attention to Carissa who are asking me something. Answer what you've been asked. Carissa asked, so Tante Gita, do you have any experience of presenting? Well, Carissa, when I was a baby, then the answer will be so long. Don't do that. Just focus on, you are asked whether I ever make a presentation or not. Or probably, Kenzie is asking, Tante Gita, do you ever feel nervous before presentation? Well, Kenzie, I always eat well. I always sleep well. So it's not a problem for me. Is it answering the question whether I get nervous or anxiety before the presentation? No. So try to focus on the question and then try to answer what you've been asked. Okay. The next thing, try to answer honestly and stay calm. Why this point is actually important? There's possibility someone is asking you something beyond your understanding, beyond your topic, or something that you don't know. Okay. Do not feel hesitant to admit, I'm sorry, I don't think I can answer that question because I'm not familiar with that particular question. Okay, so probably I might actually search it first. One day, if we have opportunity, I will answer you. That's better, rather than you are making up. I think, yeah, that's very good and something, the thing that you are not sure about it. Okay, do not actually, what is it? Answer something that just in your imagination. If you know something, you answer. If you don't know, just admit that you don't know. Even if your teacher is asking, how come you don't know? This is actually in our lesson last week. Ma'am, I will actually learn again. That's actually my mistake. I forgot about that particular thing. Rather than answering wrongly, I think I will read again in the house. And inshallah, tomorrow I will actually answer the question. That's better. Just be honest. You might also encourage question if you're audience is too passive. Anyone want to ask? Anyone to want to confirm something? Anyone to add my presentation? That's actually the way you are encouraging. And then don't forget, because this is actually group, if you are actually in the group presentation, take turn. Okay. The Gita, I know everything and I can answer better than my friend. This group work. Okay. Not your individual work. Make sure you share. Even though you really want to answer and then you know the answer better than your friend, you can actually whispering on him or her. I think you should answer. He's actually confused. Okay, but make sure you divide the portion equally with your friends. And finally, during the closing, you can actually address the person who asked, thank you very much for Aisha, Audrey, Carissa, Kenzie, Aisha, Nafisa for asking today. So it's very valuable input for me. So thank you very much. You just actually address them. So they feel, she's actually mentioning my name again. So it means that she really listened to my question. So that's actually having a good impact. And at the end of the day, all the good impact will turn, inshallah, to the good mark of yours, okay? Because your teacher is actually paying that particular small things. Whether you are actually putting on a good outfit. Every time I see my student is trying to do their best, if not you putting on the uniform, putting something that matching, let's say, all orange, although it's actually different types of clothes, it actually give me the idea that, oh, they prepare very well. They are actually really have very good intention to perform well, to perform as formal as possible. Additional mark will be given. That's actually very normal and very common. It happened to the teachers. We actually finished our session. Now I just want to give you the examples. Okay. Hopefully you can hear. You hear actually? I'm not sure whether you can hear it or not. I should share it. Okay. I just want to try whether you hear or not. Can you hear it? Okay, you cannot hear. Okay, then I have to share it first. Okay, I have to. This is one. I have to share computer sound. Thanks God, Tante Dara is already practicing with me yesterday, so I know what to do. But hopefully you can hear now. Please pay attention to this example. Example number one, the trailer from the King's Speech. Sorry.
My husband is, he's required to speak publicly.
I have received
perhaps he should change jobs.
And what if my husband were the king? My husband has seen everyone.
Insert them into your mouth. Enunciate.
He hasn't seen me. I can cure your husband, but I need total trust. What was your earliest memory?
I'm not here to discuss personal matters.
Well, why are you here then?
Because I bloody well stammer!
But do you know any jokes?
Timing isn't my strong suit.
Your methods are unorthodox and controversial.
Up comes your royal highness.
It's actually quite good fun.
Yes. Art thou afeared?
It's your peculiar.
I take that as a compliment.
War with Germany will come. And we will need a king whom we can all stand behind.
He's afraid of his own shadow.
The nation believes that when I speak for them. But I can't speak.
You could do it. You needn't be governed by fear.
It'll be like Mad King George the Stammer. Get up! You can't sit there! Get up!
Why not? It's a chair.
That is St. Edward's chair.
People have carved their names.
Listen to me! Listen to me!
Why should I waste my time listening to you?
Because I have a voice!
Yes, you do.
Your greatest test is yet to come.
What's he saying?
I don't know, but he seems to be saying it rather well. Your first wartime speech.
Broadcast to the nation and the world.
This great time of crisis.
However this turns out, I don't know how to thank you.
Okay. Anyone remember with the quote that I used in the beginning of our presentation? Can anyone actually turn on their device and then answer me? Anyone can remember that?
All great speakers were
once not great speakers.
Yes. Okay, thank you. Is it Lutfi? And who else is answering? Because I cannot see all of you here at once. So
it was me.
Okay. Anime. Thank you very much, Ani. All great speakers were once not good speakers or bad speakers, right? So it's also this king. The king is actually King George the Sixth, the mother of the Queen Elizabeth, okay, leader of the UK now. Now, so this is actually the real story. He has difficulties in speaking. He's actually having political tremor. He cannot actually speak very well. But somehow, with the practicing more and more, somehow he can actually handle those anxiety and then start speaking as a king. So it's normal for you if you are in the first, second, third, or I don't know how much presentation that you will actually feeling nervous about, but then somehow just keep going. One day you will actually get used to it and then feeling so easy when presenting something. Okay? Now we move to the second example. Please pay attention. I will hold, I will stop the video in the middle and then I get back to you to give you a question.
Hello everyone. Welcome to Public Speaking. Today's first presenter is Ranjit, and I would ask everyone to give him their full attention. Chantal, could you dim the lights, please?
The British imposed a lot of unpopular taxes on the American colonists and didn't let them elect representatives to the British government. In retaliation, the Americans started to boycott British goods. In 1773, Americans in Massachusetts dumped a shipload of British tea into Boston Harbor. This became known as the Boston Tea Party. As punishment, the British imposed laws known as the Intolerable Acts, including the Quartering Act, which made Americans let British soldiers live in their homes. Some of the American colonies created a Declaration of Rights and Grievances, which they sent to Britain, but the British just sent soldiers to the colonies to put down any rebellion. This led to the first battles of the Revolution at Lexington and Concord.
Okay. Can anyone help me? What's wrong with Rajit's presentation? Okay, one by one.
Can I?
Sure.
I think it's too boring because
too boring.
He was just reading. He was just reading from the text, and he wasn't actually looking at the audience.
Okay.
And he wasn't actually looking at the audience.
And then, okay, it's boring, it's actually reading, and then he's not looking. Okay, Lutfi, next.
His inflection was not interesting. It didn't grab your attention.
Very good, very good. The voice. Probably people at the back of his classroom cannot hear anything what he's saying, right? The inflection is not good. Okay, any other people, any other member of this group want to add? What will be the... I am not saying mistake. What will be the weaknesses of Ajit's presentation?
He didn't give any eye contact.
He didn't give any eye contact. Yes. Like Rafi's already saying, he's not even look at his audience at all. Any other thing?
He doesn't have a good introduction. And his
Exactly. No one is actually hooked into his presentation. Because he's not actually giving a big impact or a big bang to his earlier in the presentation. Introduction is just like, okay, so this will be another boring thing. Probably his audience will think that way. Any other thing?
He didn't do any hand gesture.
Sorry, one by one?
He didn't use any hand gesture.
He didn't use any hand gesture correctly. He just kept excellent reading and then holding his paper. That's it. Any other thing?
He didn't have a good outfit.
He doesn't have a good, sorry?
Outfit!
Can you see he's actually putting on jeans and then t-shirt? It's good, okay. Any other idea, guys?
He didn't prepare by turning off distractions like ringtones and that stuff. He didn't prepare. His phone rang in the middle of the speech.
He didn't prepare. He's actually not turning off the phone. Okay, probably for some of you are still in the school, you are not allowed to use the phone. But for the one in the university, you might actually hold your phone anywhere. And then don't forget to turn it off. Even you are the audience, you need to turn it off within the classroom. Okay, some teacher, some lecturer cannot appreciate the ringtone that's actually ringing. For me, usually I make a joke if hello, yeah, oh please, you can actually accept your phone outside, something like that. I will just make a joke. I won't make a problem with that, but not every lecturer will do the same. They might get insulted. You should turn off effort. Okay, now we just actually see what will be the opinion of the
those laws known as the Declaration of the Revolution Act.
I know it's very hard to give a presentation in front of
the lecturer
entire
is so
class.
Wise. Okay.
Now, would anyone like to offer Ranjit constructive feedback about his presentation? Any tips for what he might do differently next time? For example, were you all able to hear what Ranjit was saying?
Not really. He needs to speak louder and face the audience.
Yes. Great suggestion. Anyone else?
He was reading from his paper, so it didn't feel like he was really talking to us, you know?
Exactly. It's important when you're speaking to look up every sentence or two and make eye contact with someone in the audience.
It's okay to see, but
anything else that Ranjit could do to appear more relaxed and feel more confident?
He could smile more.
Yes, smiling makes us feel relaxed.
You should smile more because smiling.
And make sure your phone is off before you speak next time. So the
teacher said that don't forget to turn off your phone.
I have one more suggestion. To connect with listeners, it's a great idea to use a personal story or experience as an example. Can you try that next time?
You also can use your experience or story.
Next week, my presentation will be about the causes and effects of stress.
Probably that's also another weakness of his presentation. So we see within 1 week, Ranjit has to present another topic.
Ranjit is first up again today, and I look forward to his new presentation. Jorge, could you dim the lights, please?
Please pay attention.
Good morning. Today I'd like to talk about the causes and effects of stress and how to cope with stress. Stress has many causes, including work or school, life events, changes, or unrealistic expectations of yourself. Some effects of stress include headaches, trouble sleeping, depression, or lack of concentration. I know how hard it can be to deal with stress. Last year, I started working after school to save for college. But I didn't have time to do homework and my grades went down. I had trouble sleeping, I only ate junk food, and I stopped hanging out with my friends. Fortunately, I was able to talk with a school counselor to manage my stress. She suggested that I reduce my hours at my job, eat healthy foods, and get some exercise. So I literally started walking home from school and bringing my lunch. I also asked my teachers for extra help. Now, I feel better. It's important to recognize when you're stressed and to ask for help. Thank you.
You see, he also have a good conclusion. Can you see the difference between Ranjit a week before and Ranjit now? Okay, it doesn't have to be fancy or everything else, but he maintained everything. He maintained the eye contact. He maintained, volume clearly. And then he gave examples. His outfit is actually different. And then he's actually more confident about his topic. he give experience. And then if you might notice that he give conclusion at the end of the day, at the end of his presentation. Okay, so that's all the thing that you might do. Sum up. These are the things that I've been talking about for the last more than 1 hour. What will be the summary tips of public speaking? Preparation, of course. Know the audience, know your topic. You can master the material using cue card or index card. You need to practice. You need to maintain the time limit. You might actually exercise the possible Q&A. Okay? So you might ask your friend to ask you, or your family to ask you, so you can actually answer properly. You are not memorizing, like, that you are not memorizing. You internalize inside you, so you know if something happened, the thing is I should convey about this point. Body language, try to stand up straight, so to maintain your posture. You see, the Rajit is not like doing this. He's actually moving, but the thing, his posture is actually straight. His hand gesture, he just like, making example by using his hand. The other hand is actually holding the notes. Moving body, but not widely. Be confident. Look your best. Because I have to say the first impression count for your lecturer, for your teacher. Okay? You might wear the clean clothes. You comb your hair. Okay, you're not like waking up from your sleep. And then forget to smile. Rajit is actually smiling, right? Was smiling in the second presentation. Maintain the eye contact. Remember, only if you cannot, they try to actually slightly overhead their eyes, so you still keep looking at their eyes, but you are actually not facing their eyes. Only if you cannot face the eyes, but if you can, it's better for you to look at their eyes. You might sweeping the room by doing the Z, slowly Z. It's not like doing like this. No, you just like slowly seeing the other person and then the other person in front, something like that. And finally, speak up. You need to do the formal expression, okay? Make sure it's actually proper. Do not mumble, be clear. Limit the filler words. How to limit the filler words? It's very common. Within my presentation, for sure I have many filler words, but I try to minimize by practicing or making the pause within my speech. You know what I mean? That's filler word, okay? You should try to reduce that during the formal presentation, class presentation, or any single presentation, okay? If you are actually practicing and pausing instead of speaking very fast, you might actually eliminate or limit your filler word. And finally, about the tone voice variation, the way that your voice should be able to reach the last person on the classroom. So they have to actually listen to your voice clearly. Okay. I'm just doing the filler word now, right? That's the filler word. Alhamdulillah, we finished our things today. So, any questions? Only if you have the question.
Please. I have a question.
Yes, sure, Audrey.
Yes, you mentioned that for a conclusion, you have to mention a summary. But other than that, how do you make a strong conclusion?
Okay. The strong conclusion can be, remember what Rajit said. He said, at the end of the day, you need to know when you are stressed. And you have to have a good, what is it? Have to able to search for help, isn't it? Or less he's actually talking that way. That's actually good conclusion. Summarize everything. Basically, stress is there, you have to realize it, and then you have to seek for help. That's conclude or summarize everything that he said. Of course, it's not like so detailed, because otherwise you just actually repeat whatever you say in the body, but it makes your audience, oh yeah, he's actually talking about this. Oh yeah. I remember, I want to ask how he contact the people for help, for instance. Like, that's actually the good ending, good conclusion.
So a summary would be enough. We don't need to mention any advices or any tips or anything?
You can actually, it can be both. It depends on your topic, okay? You can actually give the, like for instance, the presentation in my classroom because it's actually related to the suggestion out of, let's say, what will be the feasibility studies of building one particular business. Then at the end of the presentation, usually the presenter will say, so in the end, you might actually think about these tips in order to make your business successful. It's also something, the conclusion that actually hit your audience. Something that make them know that, oh, okay, this is actually enlightening for me. So it's actually a good thing for me. I can grab something only by listening at the end. Because it happens that at the end of the presentation, your audience not even know whether you are ending your presentation or not because you are actually very flat. As if you are still actually talking about the body of your presentation, but you already ended. So what is the point? I didn't get it. So what are the things that I can grab from this presentation? That's actually something you should avoid. So you should either do the summary, either doing actually the tip, or either actually giving another quote. It can be. Okay, as long as it makes your audience, it's like strike with the, what is it, lightning. It's like, oh yeah, I understand what's actually the point that she want to convey or he want to convey. Okay, Audrey? Yeah. Any other questions?
What if one of your group members provides the wrong information or they make a mistake in
the middle of his or her presentation, right?
Yeah.
Let her or him present it first. Okay. By the time it's finished, then you are actually talking first to him or her. Do you know that you are making a mistake or something very quickly? If you just like, I don't know. I actually go, okay, I just want to clarify about the presentation by Gita. I think what she means is, so you are not actually making your groupmates become, he's making a mistake, he should be blamed, he should be doomed or something. No, you just actually like, as if you are making a smooth amendment after finishing. I just want to clarify what she mean about this is actually this. Okay, thank you. You might ask your question now, something like that. So your friend will not be embarrassed and then your group will not be actually getting affected as well. Because if you are keep blaming, your teacher will know, oh, there is no cooperation between the thing. Why they are not actually trying to, maintain the continuity? How come one of the group is actually wrong? It happened to me. Last semester, I already mentioned to them, okay, this topic is actually very Western topic. Try to find the Indonesian context. Okay, six of them. The five students is actually giving all the Indonesian context related to Indonesian regulation, Indonesian custom, etc. Only one person is not even explaining what I ask. So he's actually keep explaining about the American context and etc. I said, you actually read my notice in the group? Yeah, and then something like that. But the thing I appreciate is the story behind that, this person is actually doesn't want to do a group meeting. He just want to do whatever he do by himself. He doesn't want to actually asking opinion from the other group members or cooperate. He just actually do whatever he want. And then his friend is trying his best. But I appreciate because his friend is not actually blaming him in the middle of the presentation. It's not like, doesn't want to listen to us, ma'am. You see, five of us is actually making a good thing. Only him. So he's the one who is actually making mistake. It's not us. He's actually give him a different mark from us, something like that. I really appreciate they are not doing that. Okay. Just like silence, but the head of the group saying, sorry, ma'am, maybe that's our mistake that we miss one part of our presentation, not Indonesian context. So I really appreciate that. You should not actually blame your group member in front of them. But your teacher must be understand. Like for me, my case, I directly actually individually contact the head of the group and saying, what actually happened? You can explain to me now. And he explained. Basically, really hard for us to contact him. So we are trying our best. That's actually the end result. We are sorry that our group is not perform well, ma'am. Enough. Then make separate marking for them, for that person, and then for the other four. Okay. So better not blaming your friend in front of the audiences. You just actually take the responsibility because that's group work. Clear enough, Lutfi?
Yep.
Okay. Any other question? Or it's clear enough? If it's clear enough, then I will ask you things. Okay. So I move to the thing. If possible, do you mind to actually now type in the dialogue box? I have three questions. Okay. Please type your name, Q1, and then your answer. Okay. I want you to give your opinion about our program today, whether it's helpful or not, whether it's actually boring or not, whether anything you might want to say, just say it. That's fine. Or simply, you don't have to put your name, it's fine. Just Q1 and then give your opinion, that will be fine. Okay, it's up to you. Okay, I'm waiting for you. I'll give you 1 minute to actually type your response.
Wait, so where do we type it?
In the dialog box, in the chat box. It has the chat box, isn't it?
Oh, yeah, Dara? Okay.
Is there any chat box on the Dara? Oh, yes. Yeah. There.
Okay. There is already the answer.
Okay. Okay, I got one response now.
Silakan teman-teman ketik pendapat kalian mengenai acara hari ini.
One, two, three. You have 1 minute, Tante Dara, for them to answer the first question.
1 minute, enough?
I don't know. 2 minutes, 3 minutes?
Okay. And you also can type in any language. Kamu bisa juga ketiknya dalam bahasa Indonesia, nggak masalah.
Betul. You can actually type in bahasa Indonesia, yeah. Bahasa Arab, kita will, and Tante Dara will actually try to translate using Google Translate. Okay. Hopefully.
Should I read it out loud?
Yeah, you can, Tante Dara.
Zaid comments, I learned something new. And then from Audrey, it was very informative and clarifies my doubts. Lutfi, I think it was good and helpful, especially for group presentation, although somehow it felt slow.
Okay.
I think this program is very educational. Aisha, it was very helpful and I learned new skill. Raihan, it was pretty good and it will inshallah help me in the future, inshallah. Isan, it was good and it's very helpful and the information will stay with me till university, inshallah. And I hope
Amin.
To good university, Isan. Karissa, the presentation was extremely informative and beneficial to future presentation, inshallah. Mm-hmm. Dafa, it helped me a lot and was very interesting. Today, I learned a lot about public speaking and what I should do in a public speak, which is very helpful.
It makes me very
you
happy.
You can start your know. YouTube channel now, right, Rafi, with this class. The lesson, Iza, from Iza, the lesson was very helpful for me. I always struggle to do my presentation in class. So this will help me a lot, inshallah, Iza. Can you, I hope you can do better now, yeah? Nafisa, it's very good. I get to know more about public speaking. Adriel helped me improve my ability to talk with many audiences during presentation. How about Alicia? Is this Adriel or Alicia? Zaid, it was very helpful. Rafif, I got some useful information out of it. The video especially was useful in showing the difference between good and bad presentation. Yeah, because I know Rafif is very visual. He learned a lot from movie, right? Aska, it was very good and it is easy to understand. Oh, good. Great, and Rachat, great and helpful, because when I be in group presentation, I usually don't do anything because I am bad at speaking. But now I know how to speak publicly for the future. Wow, mashallah, Rashad. Darren and Rafier, we think it was a very informative regarding public speaking, as it's not a topic we usually seek to know more about. The highlight of the presentation, in our opinion, is the end of it, where a video shows exactly what is and what isn't correct. Aira, thank you very much. You're welcome. This lesson is very helpful. Inshallah, it will make me feel better when I feel like running away in a class presentation.
Okay. I think everybody has comment. Everybody does a good job. Thank you very much. Okay, now let's move to the Q2. This is not compulsory, but the thing is, if there is something that you want to know more, we might actually, Tante Dara especially, she might actually find something that useful for you. What will be the other topic that you will suggest or need for the next session? Okay, our first session is about public speaking. What will be the thing that you need, especially related, anything related to your class, related to your study, related to your daily life, or probably? So you might suggest here, and you might start to type it now. It's okay if you don't have any idea now. You can actually tell me or Tante Dara anytime, or Tante Linda. We have Tante Dara, and Tante Linda is actually the one that manage the Bermain Bersama Anak. So we can actually tell her or tell them anytime. Any suggestion for the next session? Okay, study more effectively. Okay. Any other suggestion, guys? Group and project assignment. Okay, struggle a lot, Zvi. How to keep knowledge and not forget them. You can burn your book and then mix with your tea. No, I'm just joking.
Okay. There's a lesson about it, Tante Gita. Lesson is talking about learning how to learn.
That's true. A lesson on how to manage or lead or play in project or assignment. Your opinion, we will take on mine. Hopefully, we can actually have the session regarding that. But the thing is, time management. Ah, Rafi. Okay, for the time management, I think, Tante Dara, you should ask someone. Not me.
Yeah.
I'm not too good about time management either. Leadership. Ah, good idea also. Session time management, Rafi, good. Okay, leadership would be nice. Fine, okay.
Rafif just asked me, I can suggest any idea? Yes. How about if Gita doesn't know it?
Any idea. I said it's not only related to your school. Daily life, probably something that you need to know or you want to know, okay? We cannot like 100% promising that we will offer that, but we will try our best. Yeah, Tante Dara, Tante Linda, we will try our best. Okay,
adjust with your need. This is our hobby now.
because you guys also have to actually stay at home most of the time. So probably by this thing, at least you got something out of just like lying down or playing your mobile or your games. Okay, not to it's a very good one. Procrastinate is actually my middle name. Unfortunately, I cannot actually provide that one. The topic is very... I also struggle with procrastinate. But sometimes, this is my argument, is that procrastinate is actually a good thing if you know that you have due date, you know what are the things that you need to do. How to control our nervous and boost our confidence. Okay, thank you, Kenzie. Okay, concentrate on work away from distraction. Rashad and Iza, more or less about procrastinate, right? Procrastination is actually when you have to do something instead of doing that, and you are actually distracted by something else.
Like you know it.
You have you know you have to actually have a due date assignment to do. Instead of doing assignment, you are actually making a craft, for instance, or playing a game, or playing with your cat. That's actually more or less a procrastination about. Okay, that's it, guys.
Kenzie, I just talked to Tante Sinda. I said to Tante Sinda, I will make a class bagaimana membuat bagaimana PD seperti muka tembok.
Iya, nggak usah khawatir, Kenzi. Jalankan yang masih kecil ya, Tante Dara ya.
Emang, it's actually a normal thing, Kenzi.
Okay. Even us adult, walaupun kita ini mama-mama juga masih banyak yang pemalu kok.
Yes.
I told you earlier, guys. You. Tante kita pun begitu. Even like for today, not to procrastinate. I know about not to procrastinate. I know Iza, but the thing is, I'm usually making procrastinate as my excuse to be focused on something. So I'm not the one who should do the particular topic because I'm actually enjoying procrastinate as long as I know the limit. But that's not something you should do. That's actually a bad example. And about the nervous, yeah, of course, the nervousness actually will hit everyone. Tante kita juga nervous, tante kita juga gugup, tante kita juga panik. Do you think I'm actually confident enough? Keep thinking whether you will get something from this presentation. Keep thinking whether it's actually good enough or not. Tante Dara might actually become the witness. Berapa kali PowerPoint tante kita ganti ya, Tante Dara?
Iya.
Yeah. Aduh, kayaknya harus gini nih formatnya. Aduh, kayaknya nggak jelas ya. Masih terlalu banyak kata-kata di dalam PowerPoint. Too many words inside my PowerPoint. I should find. How come the color is actually you might not see the color. I have to change this. And then how many PowerPoint that I sent to Tante Dara just to Tante Dara I change a bit. Tante Dara add something. Normal. So as long as you are prepared. Usually it help you at least quarter or half of your nervous. It will help you quarter or probably half of your what is anxiety. So if you
I think Tante Gita, if I can add, maybe you can share your anxious or your anxiety with someone close to you. Like Tante Gita keep talking to herself, but I listen to her, so maybe I just like
a little bit. Actually easier for me because I keep telling Tante Dara, and Tante Dara said, no, it's enough. And then I keep actually telling to my daughter, Tunisa, and something, yeah, Mama. Sometimes she's actually correcting, Mama, you pronounce it wrongly. Oh my God, I know my English is not perfect. For sure, your English is actually perfect. That's another anxiety point of me. Okay, you actually understand what I'm saying? Is it my English actually, can be decoded, can be understood by you properly? Also my anxiety point, but the thing you will never actually can do if you keep those things in your mind all the time, you cannot move on. Okay, I think it's finally Kenzie is actually giving the thing. Now my last question. The session was held by Bermain Bersama Anak. That's actually a group by Tante Dara and Tante Linda who initiate that, and could you follow their Facebook and Instagram if you want? Okay, they have Instagram and Facebook. So you, if you want to know the information, the latest information, probably you it can be useful for you or your other family. And then, can you say something about bermain bersama anak? Can you say something to bermain bersama anak? Sorry, they are ready. Thank you very much for me. Thank you very much, Tante Linda and Tante Dara, for having this session.
Okay, so, give big applause to Tante Dara.
If you can actually say something to bermain bersama anak, for me, I said thank you for having this thing. It's very happy to for me to actually share things with this bright students. No, this bright teenagers, I have to say. Okay.
And by the way, guys, you're practicing your public speaking today by live on YouTube channel.
Okay, regarding that. So the question three, can anyone is actually commenting something or giving some feedback to bermain bersama anak who have distance? Thank you, Gita, thank you, Kenzie, etc. Last thing. Please, everyone pay attention. I won't take your more time. I have to give you a homework. It seems that most of you say that I got something, I learned something. Well, probably some of you already know, but the thing is, oh yeah, I because Tante Gita is emphasizing those things again, so I remember. Now, please do your homework. I'm asking you to make a 15. Remember, I give you strictly 15 minutes presentation the video, and you might choose the topic, any topic that you like. Oh, my topic is about Lego. Fine. I want to say something, just my topic that I already present in my classroom last semester. Fine. I want to present about how I learned something from today. Fine. Any topic. It's actually anything. I won't limit, but please make sure do it in a formal way, okay? Whatever I just mentioned, please trying to make sure that you are following those suggestions, okay? And please send it to my email address, gita.gayatri@ui.ac.id, and then I will give you a feedback. Now, about the due date, can you actually do it within 3 days or 5 days? Okay, the topic is any topic that you like, Aira. It's a video. If you can combine the video and the slide, that will be fun. Let's say you can use the Google Meet. 1 week, Rafi? Fine, 1 week will be okay. What Rafi is suggesting 1 week. How about the others? Okay, I just tell you, just try to find Google Meet. If you have any Google Mail, you can use Google Meet. Okay. Google Meet, you can actually record. If not Google Meet, you can use Zoom. You can use also, let's say, Skype. Okay. Any topic, Rashid? Yes, any topic. I will discuss about the topic later. The thing is, you can actually present and then share the document while recording at the same time. Or probably you are actually displaying with your laptop next to you, and then your mom, your brother, your sister, or probably your dad is actually filming you. Make a video of you. That also will be fine. Yes, Rashad, any single topic. You can actually discuss about, let's say, my laptop. Okay, about gaming. You want to actually, yes, you record it, and then give it to my email. That's true, Rafi. You want to discuss about your mobile phone. You want to discuss about Lego, like I said. I want to discuss about, let's say, my shoes, because I got the new shoes from my mom. Fine. I want to discuss about the global warming. Fine. I want to discuss about, let's say, how to reduce the plastic usage. Fine. Okay. Remember, in the very beginning, in your email, you might say, this is actually informative. Even you can actually making a joke, let's say a stand-up comedy, because it's actually entertaining purpose of public speaking, Tante Gita. Fine. So it can be public speaking purpose is entertaining or informing or persuading. Okay? Remember the three things in the beginning I taught you? Okay? Is it clear to everyone what are the things that actually become your homework? Once again, because only Rafi who asked for 1 week, so is it 1 week is enough? So I expect Sunday next week, I will receive the emails from you. Okay? I will send, do you need the PowerPoint, guys? Do you need the PowerPoint? You can turn on your microphone. If you need the PowerPoint, then I can actually send it to you or to your mom.
Yes, please, Tante.
Okay, I will send it to you. So it's actually, you can also record my...
Sorry, Tante Gita, you can just send it now from chat, box chat.
Sure.
Uh-huh. Thing, you can just get it.
If I send to the chat box, will you be able to download it now? It's a bit big, actually. Let me check. Can you send to my mom? Yes, I will send again to your mom. Don't worry. The thing you can actually check it from here as well. If you can download it now, then you can download. Wait a minute. This is in. What did I say? Public speaking. What is the title? I forgot even. Okay, this one, this speaking Gigi. Is it PowerPoint? Yes, I think it's PowerPoint. It's 25.29 megabyte. Hopefully you can actually download it from there. Never mind. Okay. So you understand about your homework, right? Mm-hmm. Okay, what other thing that you need to do? Please send me. Okay, Tante Gita, I don't have time. Okay, fine. But if you would like to try and then get a feedback from me, then you can send it. So this one is probably, I don't know, Tante Dara, is it compulsory or not? I don't think it's compulsory. It's up to you. But only if you want. Okay, feel free. If you want to get the feedback, then I'll give you the feedback. Or probably this, probably that. Hopefully by listening.
Can be. If you just learn French, maybe you can just speak in French.
Yes. Any language, yeah. I'm not actually limiting only English. I want to use Bahasa Indonesia because in my school is actually using Bahasa Indonesia. Fine. Then use Bahasa Indonesia. Tante Gita, I'm good in Arabic. Fine. Tante Gita will try to listen by translating with Google, for instance, or asking the native speaker to translate for me. Fine, anything. When I said anything, then anything. You can actually choose anything. Okay, I think the file is almost done, hopefully. About the video, I'm not sure whether the video is actually transferred or not. Oh, I don't think anyone speaks Arabic. Maybe it'll be. I'm not sure.
I can speak Arabic.
Zayed, is it Zayed? Zayed, you can speak Arabic. Wow.
Okay, Tante Gita already sent.
Okay.
You can download it now.
You can download it now.
Tante, I'm sorry, but where did you send it?
In the chat room,
in the group chat.
I don't think we have it yet.
Oh, really?
It's written. It's not there.
I got so, it.
Before Zayed, so the last one is actually Lutfi saying, Rafi.
Yes.
Rafi, and then Lutfi, and then Zayed, and then that's actually the PowerPoint at the top of Zayed's comment. Okay, Rafi, you have to do a video or it can be a PowerPoint presentation. So the if you need PowerPoint to help your presentation, then you make a PowerPoint presentation. But the thing, when you presenting, whether you are using PowerPoint or not, I should actually see the video itself. So I see your face, your gesture. Please make sure that you are, when you're explaining, you are standing instead of sitting down. Okay. So I can actually give you a feedback. Okay. When if it is actually in the classroom context, you can do this or that, something like that. Is it clear, Rafi? Can everybody find the PowerPoint document? No, Audrey still cannot find. Carissa, can you find it? Oh, no, really? Saudara, they cannot.
I'm the only one.
You blocked or something?
I found it.
Oh, Isa found it. Got it.
Oh, Isa found it. Okay. Oh, okay. Isa, can you explain to your friend where? Okay, Isa can. Okay. So, check everyone. Okay, Zayat also can. Thank you, Zayat. So, the last one is Aira. Aira, Audrey Lee. Okay, Raihan, Aira, Audrey Lee. And then, before Zayat, after the last comment from Lutfi, can you send it to my mom? That's actually Lutfi's comment. After Lutfi comment, that's actually the PowerPoint. Okay. I tried to resend it again, but then if you cannot, don't worry, you will send to your mom. Laptop.
You need to use laptop to get the file.
Oh yeah, you need the laptop. If you are actually from your handphone, you cannot see it. That's true. Just send it again. Resend it again. But again, don't worry. We will send it to their mom, yeah, Tante Dara?
Yes, yes.
Okay.
I will. Hmm.
So, okay, while you are actually trying to downloading, I think it's enough for me. Once again, thank you very much. For you to be here with me and then hearing what I'm saying, and then I will have to return the forum to Tante Dara.
Thank you so much, Tante Gita. We learn a lot, even though we are in our home, we are quarantined, but it doesn't mean we stop learning, right? So we can still learning a lot of things, especially the ones that can help our study, because learning doesn't just only like a math, science. There is a lot of things like life skill you need to learn. Alhamdulillah. Let's say thank you so much to Tante Gita. You can open
thank
your mic.
Thank you very much. Everybody.
Thank you.
And we will send the video.
Thank you.
Right? Thank you.
We will send the video live. Next Sunday.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Inshallah, I'm waiting for your video, guys.
Yes.
Inshallah.
Yes.
Inshallah.
Okay. Yes. Thank you very much once again. And stay safe, everybody.
Yes.
Tadara, I should actually meet from the group. And thank you. Oh, yeah, I forgot to address Mas Aziz, my friend Mas Aziz. Thank you for coming, Mas Aziz.
let's say doa first, Tante Gita, before we leave the class. Alhamdulillahirrahmanirrahim. Astaghfirullahaladzim. Alhamdulillah. Asyadu ala ilaha. Astaghfirullah wa atuhu ilaih. Okay guys, so you can leave the class after you download the slide. Thank you and bye.
Thank you everybody. Bye. Bye. Bye Tante Dara, Tante Linda.
Bye. Bye.
Bye.
I can do bear walk. Later. Yay.
Oh, Mbak Gitanya udah keluar ya, Mbak?
Bye, Aira. Udah.
Oh, oke okay deh, Mbak. Thank you ya, Mbak. Jazakillah khair.
Yaki, do you want to replace it? No.